We're in a menagerie, a cage.
No!
Oh, again, it would have to be the cage. It was just perfect Star Trek. There was no, there were no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It was a creation. The characters were rich. The moments were beautiful.
You'll give her back her illusion of beauty.
And more.
And it was something that he loved dearly. Because it was honest to God, true Star Trek. It had all of the elements that Star Trek ever wanted to have in it. Some of them missed on in certain areas, but not the cage. The cage was said everything. My first involvement, had to be, of course, with Gene and through Gene. I had known him since 1960, and through a whole mess of pilots and so forth. And then when this one came up, and he had used me, you know, in everything. And so this one came up, he said, here's the chance. So not really, he wrote the part of number one first. And then he said, there, are you happy? He wrote the description of number one, and then he wrote the character. So, I mean, the part was always mine right from the beginning. And then I remember him saying, I want to have a captain and some other people on down. And he said, I want to use an alien. Can you think of a good alien type of person, somebody who's rather angular or so on? And I said, Gene, remember the guy back in when we were doing The Lieutenant that I did the episode with? And he said, yeah. And I said, go back and take a look. That's all I said. That's all I ever mentioned. Never brought it up again. Dissolve. It's about a week or two later, and on the set comes Leonard.
Mr. Spock here.
I was just looking for tall, skinny guys for a Vulcan who had some kind of menace to them. And Leonard was just one of a bunch of guys.
It was kind of funny, you know, to have the second in command first, because that was just my part. He was going to put a woman in there, somehow or other, in command.
Yeoman, you've delivered your report.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
They came back with the all of the tests that said that the public resented a female in the position second in command of a starship, and felt that it was totally unbelievable.
Now, she does a good job, all right. It's just that I can't get used to having a woman on the bridge.
They said this couldn't happen. No woman could handle this spot. And that was the end of the story. He said, get rid of her.
No offense, Lieutenant. You're different, of course.
Gene did not like the idea, of course, but he said he can fight just so much. And, of course, NBC had a lot of other things that they didn't want either, including the Spock character.
The female you call number one has the superior mind and would produce highly intelligent children.
Although she seems to lack emotion, this is largely a pretense.
So he said that he really desperately wanted to keep the Spock character, because he needed the Spock character. He knew this was going to break my heart, but he said, I've got to drop you, and we'll find something else for you somewhere along the line.
Sorry, number one.
This was my part, so of course I was hurt. But anyway, he decided to do that. He'd keep the number one character. He'd marry the woman, so that because he didn't think that Leonard would have it the other way around.
I've often said that if we had done the series with Jeffrey Hunter as the captain, he was the original captain and the first pilot, I don't think we'd have had the same chemistry. Jeffrey Hunter did not have the, as good an actor as he was, he didn't have the style that Bill Shatner brought to the captain role.
Don't you see it? Here and here.
I don't understand.
Bill's kind of much more aggressive energy made it possible for D. Kelly and I to play the roles that we played, which was kind of a comment on what he was doing, and to play off of that, whereas Jeffrey Hunter was much more internalized and much more thoughtful in his approach to Captain Pike. I think it was a combination of successful elements, good writing and chemistry of the performers that came together to make it possible to do what's now what I think people have enjoyed for years. Nothing that I would do other than what we did, with the small exception that in the earliest episodes I was stumbling to find my way. There are moments that I wish I could reshoot in the first pilot and in the first and maybe even in the second pilot in the first two or three or four episodes that we produced. There are moments where I say I was not at home in the character yet. The character had not really found me, or me, the character, quite yet. We were still fishing. And later, the character became more centered and more focused and clearer. So if I had it to do again, I'd love to be able to redo some of those first few moments. But other than that, I think it was what it had to be.